Well, students, after studying the phenomena of total internal reflection, which is the principle on which the optical fiber works, let us now see the structure of an optical fiber. What are the different parts an optical fiber is made of? So, an optical fiber is a cylindrical fiber which has three coaxial regions. The innermost region is called a core, having a refractive index mu 1. Surrounding the core is the cladding, having refractive index mu 2. Now, the refractive index of the core mu 1 is greater than the refractive index of the cladding mu 2. So, mu 1 is greater than mu 2. So, what it means is that the core is denser, cladding is rarer. Okay, so please keep this in mind. Core is made of denser material, cladding is made of rarer material. Mu 1 is greater than mu 2 always. Now, the light which passes through the fiber always passes only through the core. The light, the data which is transmitted in the form of light always is carried in the core only. It never comes out of the core. If by because of some reason it comes out, then that light is lost. So we never allow the light to come out of the core. Now the third layer, outermost layer, is called a sheath. Sometimes it is also called a buffer. It is only for protecting the inner cladding and core. It doesn't play any part in the working of the fiber. So this sheath is just to, it's a plastic layer. It's just to protect the inner layers from might be damage, scratches, contaminant, moisture, dust particles, etc. Okay, so these are the three regions of the optical fiber: core, cladding, and sheath. Now, the size, what is the entire size of this fiber? It, in this diagram, it seems to be quite big, but a practical optical fiber is just about 50 to 100 to 200 microns in size, slightly more thicker than the hair of the head. Okay, so it's a very thin fiber. What material is the fiber made of? The fiber is, the core and cladding are normally made of glass or good quality plastic. Okay, and the sheath is made of plastic. It is just a protective layer. So, this is about the optical fiber, a single optical fiber. And both these diagrams are basically representing the same optical fiber. This diagram shows the cross-sectional view of the fiber, and this one shows the longitudinal cut section of the fiber. Next, we'll see now how light propagates through an optical fiber. So, we know, we have already mentioned earlier that light propagates through the fiber based on the principle of total internal reflection. So, now we'll see, even if we have a fiber which is slightly bent like this, how light entering one end can propagate through the fiber and come out through the other end without almost any loss. Okay. So, in this diagram, I have only shown the core and the cladding. The outer layer I have not shown, the sheath, the protective layer, because it doesn't play any role in the working of the fiber. So, just to keep the diagram simple, I have not shown the outermost layer. Now, light which enters the fiber from one end, after slightly bending, because it goes from air to might be glass, this core is made of glass. So, after slightly bending here at the boundary, it then travels through the core in a straight line. Okay? Then, after traveling in a straight line, it hits the core cladding boundary here at this point. So, it meets the boundary of the core and cladding. Now, remember the core is denser, the cladding is rarer. So, this ray of light is going from core to cladding, is going from denser to rarer medium. So, it satisfies the condition required for total internal reflection, the first condition. And we'll assume for the moment that here the angle at which the light is falling on the core cladding boundary is greater than the critical angle. So, both the conditions are satisfied. It travels from denser to rarer, and the angle at which it is incident is greater than the critical angle. So, under these circumstances, the light at this point doesn't go into the cladding, but fully gets reflected back, undergoes total internal reflection back into the denser medium, which is the core. So, the light comes back into the core. Then again, it travels in a straight line till it meets another core cladding boundary at this point. Again, at this point, it's trying to go from core to cladding, so denser to rarer medium, and again, assuming that the angle at which it is incident is greater than the critical angle, the ray again here at this point undergoes total internal reflection. So, in this way, through multiple total internal reflections, the light propagates through the fiber and finally comes out from the other end without much loss. Okay. Now, how many reflections do you think occurs in a fiber? Now, in this diagram, I have shown 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Just for illustration purpose. But in a practical fiber, the number of reflections, total internal reflection taking place are much, much more higher. Okay. So, just to give you an example, a fiber about around 1 meter in length, just a 1 meter length long fiber, the average number of total internal reflections taking place from one end to the other end is about 10,000. So you can see it's a very large number. Okay, and you can just imagine if a fiber was 1 kilometer or 2 kilometer or might be 10 kilometers long, which is normally the case in the case of data transmission. We send data over long distances, over kilometers long. So you can imagine how many total internal reflections will take place inside the fiber. Okay, and imagine if at every reflection some energy was lost, then by the time the light would have reached the other end, the energy, the intensity of the light would have been very, very, very low, almost zero. Okay, so but remember, in total internal reflection, there is absolutely no energy loss at the reflections. Okay, so even after traveling over kilometers long distance, the intensity of light is almost the same. Slightly decrease is there, no doubt, but it's considerably high even after traveling over long distances. So this is how light propagates through the fiber using the phenomena of total internal reflection. Even if the fiber is slightly bent, it can propagate through the fiber and come out from the other side using the phenomena of multiple total internal reflections. Next part in this lecture will be studying about what is called as an optical fiber cable. Okay, so it's called an OFC, optical fiber cable. Now, what is an optical fiber cable? It is basically a collection of many optical fibers. Sometimes in this diagram, I have shown 6 optical fibers. There could be 10, there could be even 20 optical fiber cables. So depending upon how much data you have to send or data you have to transmit. So in this optical fiber cable, I've shown 6 optical fibers. So here, these, what you see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, these are optical fibers. Now these optical fibers are equally spaced around a central steel cable. This black color thing in the center is an insulated steel wire. Okay, now this insulated wire in the center doesn't carry any data. It is only to provide strength to the optical fiber so that it may not easily break if it is pulled or like that. Okay, so insulated steel cable in the center, around it there are 6 uniformly spaced optical fibers. There are also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 insulated copper wires. Okay, now this copper wires, why are they there? Sometimes you may require to send electrical signals through the cable. So if required, these are optional. Okay, so if required to send electrical signal, you may use this. Otherwise, you may leave them unused. So mostly optical fiber cables have some few copper wires also in them. Now all these things, this in central cable, the 6 optical fibers and the 6 copper wires, they are tightly bound together, held together using binding tape. So this is what you see here around is binding tape, which holds all the inner wires and the optical fibers together. Next, surrounding them is a layer of aluminium foil. So this aluminium foil acts like a shield. Remember, aluminium is a good conductor. So what it does, it shields the outside interferences like electromagnetic interference or radio frequency interference from entering and disturbing the signal inside the fibers or inside the copper wires. So this aluminium acts like a shield preventing the outside interferences from entering inside the fibers. And last on top is the aluminium is a plastic jacket, a polythene jacket, a thick plastic jacket, which protects the inner cable, inner components of the cable from damage and moisture, dust particles, contaminants, etc. Okay, so this is the structure of an optical fiber cable. Now, just to mention, it is an optical fiber cable which is actually laid down in the trenches in the road. So in the road, they did trenches and they lay down this cable. Never a single fiber is laid down separately. It's always the cable carrying many fibers in it, which is laid down in the trenches for signal carrying the signal from one place to another. Okay. Now, what is the size of this entire cable? It seems to be quite big here in this diagram. But remember, the actual normally of optical fiber cable, OFC, is of the size around 1 to 1.5 centimeters. So it's a very thin cable, but it can carry a huge amount of data. Remember, a single optical fiber can carry the data equivalent to might be something around 1000 telephone lines. So if there are 6 optical fibers in it, it can carry data equivalent of 6000 telephone lines in such a small space, just 1.5 centimeter diameter. Okay, so an optical fiber cable can carry a huge amount of data since it carries data in the form of using optical fibers. Okay, so this is about the optical fiber cable. Yeah, thank you.